guys, welcome to the video. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day. We are just sat down having some breakfast here. As you guys probably saw as I was making the breakfast really has not changed too much, even ever since prep. Like, I haven't added too much to this meal. Pretty much the only thing I've added to this meal is like some chocolate rice cakes. I'll probably do an updated full day of eating for you guys in the future here. But pretty much as I've progressed through my off season, I've mainly just been adding calories to all of my other meals throughout the day. Like, you know, my intra workout, post workout, things like this, because this meal has been doing the trick as far as kind of carbs and everything goes for my training. So we're just going ahead, sitting down and enjoying breakfast. I do like this meal as well, and that's something that's very important. It's like, if I'm enjoying it, then why go ahead and change it? But I do apologize, because you guys are probably getting tired of seeing me make egg white omelets, but that is gonna be, that's probably a trend on this channel, is the amount of egg white omelets that I've made. I should go ahead and do a counter of how many omelets I've made, but we're just going ahead and we are sitting down eating meal number one. But I thought in today's video, I would go ahead and take you guys through a little bit of a push workout. We got that on the plan for today as well. I thought I would go ahead and kind of break down, when should you increase your volume? I think that volume is one of those things that is very, very important to make sure that we are seeing continued growth, especially in an off season, and even when we should go ahead and kind of modulate that volume going into a prep scenario. So in today's video, I'm going to go ahead and, as we go through the push workout, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of tidbits here and there about when I think we should go ahead and kind of increase that volume to make sure that we are maximizing our off season to get the most growth possible. Because just on one hand, is you don't want to be doing too much volume and overtrain, you also don't want to be doing too little volume and leaving gains on the table. So that is what we are going to be talking about in today's video. But nevertheless, I'm going to go ahead, dive into meal number one here, and then I will probably catch you guys for the pre-workout. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. All right, guys, the supplement cupboard is out on the counter here. As you can see, we got quite a bit of supplements here. So for pre-workout today, we're not gonna do anything with any stims in it, because on push days, I generally don't do anything with stims in it, because as you can see, I've just been sipping on an energy drink going into this workout, so that's already 180 milligrams of caffeine. I don't need too much caffeine, because otherwise I will probably have an anxiety attack during my workout. So we're gonna go with one scoop of the Ghost Pump. This is a good little pump product. Generally, you want to do like two scoops to get the clinical dose out of this pump product, but because I'm going to be mixing it with something else, I'm just going to do one scoop of this. Which I'm going to be mixing it with is going to be the new Dilate liquid pump from ANS. So I'm sure many of you guys have probably heard of like EVP AQ from Evogen. They kind of are the ones that first started like the liquid glycerol, which is a really, really great pump ingredient. ANS has kind of gone above that, which is really cool, because now what they've added into this is almost like a full panel pre-workout, because it also has citrulline in here, which most pre-workouts do, plus some pink salt as well. So we're going to go with one tablespoon of this, which is 10 grams of glycerol, as well as 3 grams of citrulline, and then 200 milligrams of sodium. So this one's strawberry mango, which smells absolutely fantastic as well. I've been using it for like the last week. Kind of looks like Pepto-Bismol though, which is really funny. The first time I poured it out, I was like, oh, that looks a bit weird, but it smells absolutely delicious. So that is going to go in there in combination with the Ghost Pump. And then last thing I'm going to do is going to be some creatine. No reason for me putting it in my pre-workout, it's just when I remember to take it. So we're going to do about 8 grams of creatine. One thing with creatine, I've probably talked about this in previous videos before, instead of going with the 5 grams of creatine kind of blanket statement that everyone says, you really want to go with 1 gram of creatine for every 10 kilograms of body weight. That way you're actually dosing the creatine based off your body weight. If you're a larger individual, if you're a smaller individual, then you can go kind of based off of that. So that is going to be our pre-workout. It's going to be one scoop of the Ghost Pump, 1 tablespoon of the ANS Dilate, and then 8 grams of creatine. So that is going to be our pre-workout. Now, as far as intra-workout goes, we are getting a little bit further into the off-season now, so I do have a little bit more room to play around with things, such as carbohydrates intra-workout to help boost that performance. So first thing we're actually gonna go ahead and add in here is gonna be 10 grams of glutamine. Glutamine is really good for helping with gut health, actually. It's very good for gut health, but it's also an amino acid, obviously, which can help with recovery. So this is just kind of when I like to take it. I do have glutamine in the morning as well. with meal number one for that kind of gut health properties that I talked about. So we're gonna do 10 grams of glutamine. We're gonna throw some EAAs in there as well. So I'm going to do 20 grams of the Ghost Amino here to get a good dose of EAAs there intra-workout. As well, this does have some focus ingredients in it actually, and some hydration products as well, which is really great to make sure that we are staying hydrated during our workout. For carbohydrates, I'm going to put about 25 grams of carbs in there. This is just going to be coming from Gatorade powder. Now, if you have the budget for it, I definitely recommend using something such as like a highly branched cyclic dextrin or cluster dextrin, just because that is going to pass through the gastric lining a little bit easier. But if you don't have the budget for that, because it can be a little bit expensive, something just such as like the powdered Gatorade from the grocery store is a really great option as well, because this is just going to be dextrose. So most people do digest this fine. Obviously, if you're starting to get into the higher doses of it, if you're doing like 50, 60, 70 grams of carbs in a workout, you might find that it sits in your stomach a little bit. But for right now, doing 25 grams of carbs worth of the Gatorade powder has been working good for me, and it's a hell of a lot cheaper than cluster dextrin. Like I said, if you have the budget for it, then definitely go for cluster dextrin, because it is going to be a little bit better. But this is a very cheap alternative as well. So I do mix my intra-workout with about a liter of water. So then that'll put me to almost 4 liters of water before I've kind of started my workout, or while I'm doing my workout, which will keep me nice and hydrated throughout the session. That is going to be my pre and intra workout for today's push session. So I'm gonna go ahead, clean this up, head to the gym, and then I will catch you guys there. All
right, guys, we just rolled up to the gym. So what I'll normally do when I get here is it's kind of like my pre-gym routine, is I'll just go ahead and kind of sit here for like 5 minutes, sip on my pre-workout. We'll kind of listen into some tunes, jamming out a little bit, having a little bit of a jam session before going in there and kind of locking in. So we're gonna do that. We're just gonna go ahead and kind of sip on my pre-workout here, get this down, get this in me, and jam to some tunes a little bit before we go in there and get it started.
Shakira, Shakira, I never really knew that she could dance like this. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita. Where's the fun in that? Yeah, let's go put some miles on it. Back of the Chevy with the engine.
We're just listening to this hardcore screamo. What the fuck is going on? That's what's going on right now.
Okay, so the first thing we have to determine before deciding whether or not we should be ramping up volume is going to be, are you in a calorie surplus right now, or are you in a calorie deficit? If you are in a calorie surplus right now, which means you are eating above your maintenance, we can probably go ahead and handle a little bit of extra training volume because we have the extra calories to be able to handle this. Whereas if you are in a calorie deficit and you are eating below maintenance, we might not be able to handle as much of a bump in training volume just due to the fact that our recovery ability is going to be a little bit lower. So that is something to take into consideration before you go ahead and start increasing all of your volume and digging yourself into a deeper hole.
Lightweight, ain't nothing but a peanut. Gotta grow some big titties. I hope I'm not saying that too loud. I have my headphones in. Oh, that'd be awkward. Just screaming big titties in the gym.
So the second thing that we have to determine before increasing volume is, where's your current volume at and how are you recovering from that? If you find that you are doing, you know, 3-4 sets of some exercises and you are feeling absolutely battered, then your volume already might be too high for what you are able to recover from. But if you are doing, you know, 2 sets of everything and you find that you are recovering fine, within a couple of days you are fully recovered and you're not sore anymore, then you might be able to handle a little bit more volume. So assess where you are currently at with your volume
volume and how you are recovering from that, because that is going to determine whether you are able to handle more volume or not and where you are able to handle that volume. I realize I stick my tongue out a lot. It's very weird. If you watched any of my YouTube videos or Instagram videos when I'm doing reps, I'm like, I don't know why. It's weird. Just a thing I do. Attempt to do two plates on here. I don't think I've ever done two plates on here, so if we get like seven, that'd be pretty good. I got 85 for eight last week. This is 5 pounds up. So if we could get 5 pounds up and one rep less, then I'd be happy. Obviously, if we could match reps, that'd be ideal. But don't know if that's in the cards. That was 7. That was good. Probably will get 8 next week. Now that we have determined if you are able to handle more volume or not, the question comes to where should you put that volume? Now, when I'm going ahead and escalating my volume over the course of an off season, I'm going to add those extra sets in to exercise that aren't going to be super demanding. And what I mean by this is you're not going to go ahead and add extra volume to something such as like a hack squat, because the physical demand from that is going to be so fatiguing that that's going to start to drip over into your other exercises and drip over into your other sessions as well. So when increasing volume, we want to go ahead and increase the volume in the areas that A, are our weaker areas, and B, exercises that aren't going to be super fatiguing. So something such as like a side lateral raise is a great way to add in a little bit of extra volume for the side delt without creating too much extra fatigue. Because we have to think, there's only so much volume that we can handle before we are going to start creeping over into overtraining, and then all of our sessions are going to start to be affected. So when I'm thinking about adding in volume, I'm thinking about what are my weak areas and where can I go ahead and increase volume within those weak areas that isn't going to be too fatiguing, that it's going to start to drip over into my other exercises and drip over into my other sessions and affect those throughout the week. So that's something to think about when you are increasing and escalating that volume.
Alright guys, so to summarize and wrap up the video, in order to determine if you should increase volume or not, you first have to ask yourself, are you in a calorie surplus or are you in a calorie deficit? Because this is going to greatly impact whether you are able to handle that extra volume or not. Second thing you have to do is assess where your current volume is at and how you are recovering from that. If you're absolutely battered in some areas, then you probably shouldn't add volume there. Like if your legs are absolutely wrecked, you probably don't need to add more volume there. If anything, you might actually need to reduce it a little bit. And then from there, if you find that you can add some additional volume into some different areas, then first determine what your weak parts are, because you're going to want to go ahead and add a little bit of additional volume there. And when you are adding that additional volume, go ahead and add it to exercise exercises that aren't going to carry a heavy, fatiguing demand. Like, don't add it to like a hack squat or a deadlift or something like that. That's going to be super fatiguing. Go ahead and add it to some accessory movements that aren't going to carry over as much fatigue into your other exercises and into your other sets as well. If you do this, if you progress your volume over time in an efficient manner, you are definitely going to be sure to pack on some extra muscle. But guys, I'm gonna go ahead and leave the video there. I hope that you guys did enjoy the video. If you guys got value from the video, please be sure to drop a like on the video. I would greatly appreciate it. As well, if you're new around here, be sure to click that subscribe button so that you guys don't miss out on any future content. Other than that, I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace.